What's going on? It's Ayo Dele, or Ayo for short. I'm from Houston, Missouri City to be exact, really. I went to Sam Houston. I graduated with accounting, international business, double major, minor in economics. I'm a businessman, you hear me? I'm a Sigma, you know what I'm saying? Spring 18, I'm pretty sure you can see that. That Street Sanctum clothing coming out. It's a clothing line I've been working on for a little bit. I had a clothing line in college, actually it was called One Deep Clothing because I was always One Deep, you know, that's just me. I feel like it fit my identity. But even when I had that clothing line, I already knew that in the future I would have another clothing line that I would take more serious. So I use that clothing line more so to kind of figure out how the clothing line stuff worked, how to navigate it. Now, a few years later, I'm ready to start off this clothing line. It's called Street Sanctum. I'm a black man in America, right? In corporate America, you're dead. I'm an accountant. So I'm not able to really necessarily be myself at work. So I want to build a community of people that come from different backgrounds, which is where the street comes from. And can come together, you know, people that make money, entrepreneurs like myself. So community entrepreneurs from different backgrounds that can come together and not feel judged, you know what I'm saying? Be yourself. And that's where Sanctum comes from. Look up Sanctum, man. Sanctum is like a safe haven. You're welcome. You know, it's a great environment. It's a great place, you know what I'm saying? Be part of the Street Sanctum community. We're good people. If you're good people, you need to be part of the Street Sanctum community. Yeah, I just kind of wanted to walk y'all through my journey, let y'all be part of this. So far, I'll be right back, actually. All right, I'm back. So, I had a previous design, which I'm no longer going with no more, but there was a manufacturer that I found, I think off Alibaba. He made this one. I'm not doing this design no more, but yeah, you get the gist. This isn't really what I had in mind. He didn't do this part right, nor did he do this part right. My frat brother, one of my LBs has a clothing line as well, and he went to a local shop. So I tried to use that shop he sent me to. And this is what I got. It's cool and everything, but this look washed out. And I had this longer. So the quality is way better. It's just, he didn't, this is what I wanted. You know how Nipsey has these tags, you know what I'm saying? See how he, I wanted this. This is what I wanted. That's why I was like, let me go ahead and try out another manufacturer, or let me go a different route. I was disappointed. I actually placed an order with this local shop because I saw my frat brother's product, but nah, maybe I should have got a sample like I did it with the Pakistan manufacturer. That was a little minor setback. I went on Fiverr to have somebody help me really come up with a brand identity. So now I have a better idea of what direction I want to go into. I have a better idea of, I actually have brand colors. I have a slogan, which is unleash your potential, wear your confidence. You know, you gotta be confident. You gotta wear your confidence, you feel me? And you gotta unleash your potential because we all have potential. You just gotta tap it, you know? There's a lot of people with untapped potential. Unleash your potential, wear your confidence, straight up. It's expensive to be an adult, straight up. I ain't gonna cap, so I had to prioritize. I had to focus on other things, but I'm at a point where I'm really tired of living paycheck to paycheck. It's really not it. You know what I'm saying? They really didn't tell you about this part when they was telling you to be an adult, get a job, whoop-de-whoop, do this and that. Yeah, I live by myself. I got three dogs. Hey, it's hard, so I had to make sacrifices and, you know, figure out what my priorities were at the time, but now, you know what I'm saying? I'm ready. I really want to have the clothing line take off. And it's like, I feel that I have a little bit more motivation because again, I don't like this paycheck to paycheck life. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to see what this clothing line life looking like, you feel me? And really take it serious and treat it like an actual job, like an actual career. So that's the route I'm going through. I'm also a photographer and videographer, so sometimes it just depends on what I have going on at the time. Like even right now, I was editing a music video, but I need to get this taken care of because I'm really making this video because I got confirmation from this manufacturer. I'm giving him another chance. Got confirmation from Bo that he sent the shirts of these new designs that I'm working on. I actually have a few designs. I went through Fiverr to try to get some designs. I don't know if it was miscommunication. I don't know what it was. but I really didn't like the end result in those designs. I think they did the best they could do with what I told them, but I didn't really necessarily have a vision or like really know what I wanted in the design. Now, I decided to start going through Instagram because I've heard of people saying to go through Instagram and find designers on there. There's people that already have shirts designed. Once you're ready to purchase design, you let them know, hey, I like this design, how much is it, whatever, whatever. Try to finesse, try to see if you can get a cheaper price. If you can, maybe buy two designs for a cheaper price. That's how I am, but maybe it's because I'm an accountant, so plus I'm not cheating. So, hey, you know what they say. We looking for a deal. But I'm not trying to cheat nobody at the same time, so if I can't get a deal, it is what it is. If I like the design, I'ma buy it. That's how it is. That's how it goes, that's how it works. Hey, supply and demand, my brother. A sister, whatever. Or if you don't identify, whatever. Hey, all inclusive, you feel me? There's about 5 designs that I decided to actually like. Out of all of those designs, I've asked other people, would you wear any of these or would you buy any of these shirts? Or I asked them, hey, what order would you put these shirts in? So the top 2 that people seem to like the most decided to get samples made up. What I think I'm gonna do is get 50 of each shirt, see which one sells faster, and probably my next order, I'll buy more of that shirt. Or that design or whatever. But yeah, so that manufacturer, he hit me, he let me know that he sent them. So I can't wait for them to come, you feel me? So I really wanted to put the video out there because he shipped them yesterday. This is how I do it though, because I got this from Hollywood Shack. I usually split it up with more or between more payments, but the fact that it was what, $300, and he said it's gonna take him 3 to 4 days. I didn't personally see a point in splitting it up to so many payments, but I told him I'd pay half to get it started, and then whenever he showed me that it's done and packaged up and everything, I sent him the other half. Whenever I'm buying actual bulk order, I told him I'ma pay a third of it to get it started, pay a third of it whenever he shows me that he's working on it, it's already cut up, you know, since the shirts are cut and he's putting the design on it, and then pay the last third when he's, you know, saying it's all packaged up and then he's getting ready to ship it out. So I personally like the 3 payments. And so another reason why I was in limbo because I was, after that first manufacturer, I was like, all right, I don't know. I see some pros and cons. I really like the material. Like, I really like how heavy the shirt is. I really like how I washed this a million times and this still looks brand new. Better than this came when it was brand new. You feel me? So I'm like, I have an idea of what his quality is like. It just was miscommunication and I was kind of annoyed that he did. What is this? I was annoyed about this. I was annoyed about this. So I ain't really want to mess with bro. Then I was chopping up with different manufacturers. I was actually made a whole list to try to see what the price of the samples was. And then I got the quotes of the actual bulk order. So I put that down. And then that's how I decided who I wanted to go with next. One guy I decided to deal with in Pakistan. I heard Pakistan got good manufacturers and everything. So I've been trying to see what Pakistan talk about. But this dude, he gave me some stuff that I didn't like. I like the beanie that he made, right? So I had to make a shirt, a hoodie, sweatpants, and shorts, and a hoodie, a beanie. You know what I'm saying? Oh, and then I actually had to make a sleeveless shirt that was acid wash. I didn't like nothing but the beanie. I was upset because, for one, I told him exactly what I wanted. I told him the GSM. I gave him a size chart. I provided everything that I thought he would ever need, but he still did it wrong. And then when I told him, hey man, what is this? I don't like this material. What's going on with this? He was like, it basically each garment he provided me, he used a different material or a different style or whatever he said. And that was so that whenever I'm ready to make a place of order, I would know which one. Like, bro, what? I was so mad because if I tell you the specifications, I give you all the specs of what I want, and you decide to go do something else completely different from what I asked you for, I'm mad. Now I feel like you played me. He was asking me to give him another chance and I'll make another sample for free, but he still wanted me to pay for shipping. And it's like, yo, it's not my fault. So why should I have to pay for shipping when you messed up? You decided to do what you wanted to do. I'm not going for that, so. I decided I'm no longer working with him, and I'm like, let me go back to old dude because the grass ain't always greener on the other side. I feel like I might as well give bro another chance. And you know, he made them shirts real quick, so I think I'm pretty happy. I can't wait to get them shirts in and see what it's really talking about. The only thing I'm worried about is I haven't sent him pictures of everything before he shipped them out. I know for sure that one shirt is fire, A1. I really like that one. And the other shirt, I'm just kind of iffy about the color. But I don't know if it's just because of the way it looks in the picture. But it don't look like the picture that I sent him. It's a different type of yellow. And it look kind of washed out. So that's the only thing I'm really worried about. Hey, if you have any advice for me, because again, I am a new brand. I'm starting out. The what I did in college, that doesn't count. I didn't have a website. I had an Instagram for it, but it's like, man, I wasn't serious about that. I just was selling to friends. Now I'm trying to actually build a brand, and I want to be marketing. Matter of fact, I need to make me a TikTok. I think I have a TikTok, but I need to actually make content for TikTok. So whenever I'm getting my package, whenever I'm opening it up, that's going to go on TikTok. I need to really be active with YouTube. I'm a videographer, honestly, and I'm not gonna lie, I don't really post my stuff like that. I make sure my artists get their work, but it's like I'm not active on social media like I need to be. So maybe I need to get a marketing team or something, or just somebody to hold me accountable. I need to build a team for my photography business so somebody can hold me accountable from posting content whenever I do a shoot. You know what I'm saying? I think that's what I'm gonna do. I could just have a friend that I really trust that is gonna hold me accountable. I don't necessarily have to pay for it, but I think I still would want to get them like a little small percentage of whatever I make, just to make it make sense. Cause you know, I don't really want no handout. I really want to support all of my friends and my people. I think that's what I'm gonna have to go ahead and do. But hey, if y'all have any advice for me, before I wrap this up, since I ain't have no clothing yet, I was like, let me go ahead and get these wristbands so I can start marketing and advertising. I have my slogan on these wristbands. I don't know if you can see it, but it say, unleash your potential, wear your confidence. I've been selling them to some people. I've been giving them away to some people. It just depends, you know what I'm saying? Depending on how many you want, really. Now, you can get one for free, probably, but if you want more, you're gonna have to pay for them, right? Unfortunately, but that's just how it go, because I really did buy them to sell, but I'm like, you know what, you might as well give them away. Hey, one thing I'm not gonna be telling customers is that when they place an order on the site, or even if they just, you know what I'm saying, buy a shirt from me in person, I'm gonna give them a wristband, because I got a bunch of colors. I got black, I got red, I got blue, I got green, I got like teal, lime green, mint green. I got one that's like green, black, and red. I got a rainbow one. Hey, I got a bunch of colors. I got black and red, black and blue, light pink, I got dark pink. I got one that's half light pink, half dark pink. I got purple, I got lavender, I got yellow, I got this burnt orange looking color. Hey man, I got some colors, but whatever color fit you wearing, I likely got a color for that, man. And if I don't, hey, I'm probably have one shortly. I think that's about a wrap, you know what I'm saying? See what I wanted to say. I'm ashy, man. Next video, I won't be ashy. Don't be on my helmet. Don't be on my top for that, man. I'm one of them that get out the shower and I dry up, get clothes on, put my deodorant and my cologne on, but I don't. You know, I even put my beard shit on, but I don't remember to put lotion on. It's crazy. I need to put that in my routine. I won't be ashy the next video. Okay, I might. I ain't even gonna lie. I'm not the type of a lot of people. I keep it real. but ain't got no excuses. But that's a wrap, man. I appreciate you for watching. If you even did watch this far, peace.